this has started. My family is all infected. They are outside of the door. I've locked the pantry door. I've locked myself in here. I've got a weapon. I've got plenty of food. Stay here forever. Eventually, I will have to go out, and I don't want to. Okay. This is day two. Being in the pantry. I've already had some food. Not too much though, because of the obvious reason of I have to reserve it. Even if it's just me in here, it's still only gonna last me for so long. I'm already conserving the water. There's Gatorade in here. I've been drinking that in order to save the water for when I need it. I've been using these rice bags and my jacket to sleep at night. It's been the most comfortable, but it's worked. It's worked for the situation I'm currently in right now. I didn't exactly have time to grab a pillow, you know. Most I had time to grab was a weapon, that's it. When you're running from zombies, your first instinct is never, oh, I need comfort, I need a blanket. No, it's always gonna be, I need a weapon. I can still hear my family out there. They've already torn our poor dogs. Okay, I'm gonna end this early.
It's day three. Being stuck in the pantry. This is gonna be my breakfast, lunch, and dinner for the day. The noises from outside have started to get quieter, but I can still hear the footsteps. I know for a fact I'm not alone in here. In this house, I mean. God only knows how long I'll survive. Cheers. I'd like to show you what my sleeping arrangements have been like. A couple of bags of rice being used as my pillows. And my jacket currently being used as my blanket to stay warm. It's janky, but it'll do. It's about time to get some rest anyways. I wish I could turn the light off. Switch is outside. Quite cold. I'm trying my best to stay warm here. I guess it doesn't help that the apocalypse started right when winter started coming around. So this light is even on. I guess the backup generator is only really meant to keep the lights on at this point. I gotta find some way to stay warm. My family's still out there, still infected. Recently, I heard someone attempt to come into the house, and I could do nothing and just listen to my family tear the man apart. Surely, death is better for them than whatever the hell this is. I don't know if I'd have the will to pull the trigger. Most I can do right now is sleep. It's a better way to pass the time. There's no Wi-Fi. I can't go outside to use the TV because of the obvious reasons. I don't have any games in here, so I can't exactly play anything, even. And I don't have anyone to play a game with, so this is is the easiest way to pass the time. Just simply taking a nap. It's hard to get sleep now, though. Unfortunately. Get some more shut eye.
Yesterday I heard some footsteps from upstairs, heavy ones, which leads me to believe there's more zombies in the house now, which is not good. Sure to conserve my liquids because the body can survive a long time without food or without water. That's when the body starts to fail. I heard that somewhere. So far I've only drank like 2 or 3 Gatorades and there's still these gallons of water over here. And I just noticed a bottle of water up there. In fact, there's even more big jugs of water behind me. But I'm only ever going to get to those when I need to. Pistachio guy. And now, these taste fucking amazing. I present to you a performance by yours truly, because I am bored as shit. L is for the way you look at me. O is for the only one I see. V is very, very extraordinary. E is even more than anyone that you adore and love. You see, the one good thing that came out of this pandemic is that we didn't get Gal Gadot singing fucking Imagine by John Legend.
lost the milk bones that used to belong to my dogs. That's a bit of a hard topic right now. Who knows, that might be what I'm eating in the next few months. Do we have any liquor in this cabinet? Any sort of liquor in this pantry? It's red wine vinegar. Probably the closest thing. It's gonna taste like shit, but hey. To the end of the world, I guess. Yeah, no. No, I'm not doing that again. No. Some point in the future, I'm gonna need a shave. Unfortunately, I do not have that luxury right now. I remember one of these is stale. Can't remember which one though. I think it might be this one. You know what? So, I don't think I ever properly showed the weapon that I snagged when I first got in here, but here it is. It's just a simple combat knife that I bought a while back. It's fairly sharp and gets the work done. I get to actually test it though, so I can't exactly confirm whether or not it is indeed good for killing zombies, but I can say that it is definitely sharp and definitely useful in a zombie apocalypse situation. Stabbing the heads, you know, it's the more, that's their main weakness is the head. As long as the brain is intact, they can survive just about anything. Also, I haven't heard noises coming out from outside in a few days, so I think it's safe for me to talk at a fairly normal volume level. But yeah, I've still been stuck in here. Still quite cold, uncomfortable, you know, sleeping arrangements and all, but it's had to work.
pistachios. Like I said, everyone never really was the biggest fan of pistachios, but ever since I've been stuck in here, these have been one of the main things I've been eating. I don't know why. These things are good. I wish it wasn't so goddamn cold in here, though. I've started trying to figure out ways to pass the time aside from sleeping, you know? One of the main things that I've been doing is this. Shit. Hold on, I got. Fuck. One more. Damn, that was close. Okay, just one more. I probably shouldn't do this. It's wasting my food. Okay, I promise this is the last one. Five-second rule. Thank you. Thank you very much. Problem with choosing a pantry as your secret hiding place in an apocalypse is, yeah, it's got plenty of food and water, but absolutely no entertainment. Like, pretty much none. There's a pool table in our dining room, but can't exactly get to that for multiple reasons. But yeah, I've just been sitting here the entire time. I'm gonna wait a few more days, see if it's still quiet. And if it is, I will take my chances and I will go out. I do remember there being a shotgun. Actually, I think it was like a lever action rifle. I get too confused. Yes, a lever action, actually. My dad brought it out at the beginning of the apocalypse, but that was before him and the rest of my family returned. But if I can manage to get to that, I think I could definitely take out the rest of the zombies in the house. Few days. I've been sitting in here for the past couple of weeks, so a few more days shouldn't hurt, you know? See you in a few days. It's been a few days. I still haven't heard any noise, so I'm gonna go out there, make sure the coast is clear. And if it isn't, I have this. Hold on. For luck.
also really thirsty.
It's just clear now. So, hey, this is an update. I've been held up in here for the past few months. I've had the entire house to myself ever since I cleared out the zombies. And, I also found a stray dog on the property, so I brought him inside, gave him some food, and he's just been with me these past few months. And it's been nice. I've had a friend, I've had plenty of stuff to do, you know? And I'm hoping eventually I'll find other survivors, but for now I'm pretty content with my situation right now. I still have plenty of food, and even when I run out, I can easily, you know, hunt for some food in our backyard because we have rabbits and we also have fish. And I could easily just take the car and drive my way over to the Publix nearby and ransack whatever the fuck they got. But yeah, life's been pretty all right, all things considered. I don't know who exactly is gonna see these videos, but whoever does, just know, there's still hope. Whether it be in finding a stray dog, whether it just be surviving in general, there's a reason for it all. This is my last video. Signing off.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue, clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world.